Because correct me if I'm wrong, they're trying to terrify me. Let me tell you something. If I am killed because I have trusted someone, I think I'm all right with that. I'm all right with that. If my last thought is, oh, shit. I'm okay with that. I wouldn't mind my last thought being that of surprise. Oops. Because I am supposed to believe, according to the television and the medias, that 98% of the men on this planet, and I'm not exaggerating, want to rape things and diddle small children. And here's what I'm willing to say, based on the same information Nancy Grace has, which is none. No, they don't. No, they don't. 2%. Willing to go 2% of the planet. The people on the planet are broken. Men, women, all of it. And that means, yes, you should live a little defensively. 2% of 3.5 billion men? Yeah, live a little defensively. Somewhere between Nancy Grace's dream, where each of us have our own spider hole and a shotgun. Or Allen Ginsberg's beautiful 1955 poem, Howl. That is also not real. Those are not the best minds of my generation. Starving, naked, hysterical, running through the Negro streets at dawn with money taped to their ass, screaming, what's gonna happen? Those are non-realities, those two. This is reality, right here. When I was 12 years old, when this sweet, sweet package was just starting to come together, I was allowed to take 3 buses for 2 hours to downtown Milwaukee to the public library by myself. I've always thought of it as freedom. My sister has always referred to it as parental neglect. But I'm on the second bus, the long bus, like when Frodo's going up Cirith Ungol, right? The long staircase. Now, I'm on that bus. There is a bus driver. There's an old lady. There's myself at age 12. And there's one other person on this bus. There's a guy that I call Blue Collar Batman. Blue Collar Batman has a mullet. Now, here's what we all know about a man with a mullet. Instinctively know that that man has anger issues. Okay. Now, what you've never admitted about a man with a mullet is that he's working on his anger issues. That's what the haircut says. The front of the haircut says, I will go to work every day. The back of the haircut says, I don't want to. The front of the haircut says, I will help you raise these babies. But the back of the haircut says, I want to be in a band. So he's working on it. Whatever. We pull over. We pick up another man. This man is drunk. Have you ever been so drunk you're soaking wet? I have. And he was. And we know this because he sat on top of me and started playing grab ass and it was gross. Now, bus pulls over super fast. Blue Collar Batman, bus driver, run down the aisle fast. Pick him up. They throw him off the bus. Bus driver kicks him. Blue Collar Batman crouches in front of me. Doesn't touch me, just crouches. And he says, come sit by the old lady. Come sit by the old lady. And I sit by the old lady and she pats my hand and says, you'll figure it out. Worst advice ever. And then Blue Collar Batman proceeds to tell a story that he has clearly told many times before, which is, you gotta protect women. You just have to. That's what I told the judge when I almost beat that guy to death with a pool cue. Well, we're all uncomfortable now, sir. Doesn't mean I don't appreciate that guy's good works, quite honestly. Because think about it. That guy's not a rapist. That guy's not a child molester. Granted, he is a man that is looking for someone he might be allowed to beat the shit out of. That everyone will be pleased about. But he's working on it. Okay, so that's Exhibit A. Exhibit B. How many women in this room have made, shall we call them, interesting life choices? Where you followed a dude down an alley with the promise of weed and adventure. I have 6 of those stories. And they all end the same way, which is, and then I wasn't killed.